Next up, I'm attaching all my layers together. So, putting face up on the table, your outer fabric with the trim, and then placing the lining and your coutil that was sewn together earlier with your boning in. Face up with your seams up. Then starting at the centre, making sure all your boning is pushed right up. I've pinned and then now I've tacked and taken the pins out, the layers together. I shall be sewing all the way along here, set 1 centimetre in to here, and then I'm going to turn it around on the machine and sew a line all the way up where I've put these marks as a guide to help me. And then I will be stopping. I will not be sewing right the way to the top here. I will be stopping at the coutil right there and do the same for the other side as well. Okay, we've now sewn along the bottom edge as instructed earlier, down to the corner and then up to the top edge of the coutil, and we've clipped the corners ready to turn inside out, and we've clipped along here as well where the curve is, and on the other side as well. As you know, to be careful when you're doing this not to cut right up to your sewing line. Okay, afterwards, if you've turned it inside out, you need to give the bottom edges a press with the iron. Iron them nice and flat. And coming to the back here, you also need to press the edges, the seam edges on the back, so they're nice and flat. Should look something like this at this stage. Okay, next I'm going to be sliding in my last pieces of boning down the last section at the back, and to do that I've run a sewing line about a centimetre in to create my last channel, and then I've just popped that in, and then it's just a case of very carefully sliding that in. Next you have to run another sewing line roughly about a centimetre in all the way up. This is to make it ready for putting the eyelets in. Make sure you do that for both sides. Next, before we do the eyelets, we have to turn over the edges on the lining. So you're turning it inwards and you're turning it in at the top, and then just doing little catch stitches by hand. And then you're continuing around the armhole, little catch stitches. First thing though, what I recommend is, you can see here there's some pins, it's pulling the lining quite tight. I'm turning it over and pulling your outer fabric as well and pinning it in place so that it holds it tight. Otherwise, after you've catch stitched it in place, you'll end up with a lot of slack. So that's what I've done that for. You still got to have a little bit of slack here and there, but you don't want it to be excessive. So this is pins, is just holding it all together while I catch stitch around the edges. You then of course need to do the same around the other side. The top of your lining, turning that in, and then, sorry I'm trying to film here and same time, but you get the idea, you're just turning that edge like that. And then again around the edges of your armhole. I've cut the black coutil inside shorter because it was actually getting quite annoying trying to turn over and it was just too much bulk. So it's a bit of a lesson learned here. In future, I think if I put cotille in anything, I'll be cutting it a bit shorter, because it's making turning the fabric over around its armhole a little bit tricky. As we know from when I did my sleeve earlier, putting this piece of ribbon on the strap, it has to turn in that way, like so, when it's on my arm. But when I came to do the armhole, I needed that seam to be, that edging, sorry, to be turned inwards the other way. Otherwise we would have had a bit of issue near the top. And that one side of the sleeve edge is going one way and one the other. And we already know that the top of the sleeve has to go over the top of the arm. Again, this is really tricky trying to film because Mum's busy. Like that when it's in the arm, so just here. You just want to do a little snip, being very, very careful. So I'm just going to start at the other end, start turning my edges in and working towards the centre. As you can see, I finished at the centre here, my little catch stitches, and then we've got the front. This is more or less what it should look like when you finish catch stitching the edge of your lining all the way along. You can just see my little stitches, just catch stitching that in place all by hand and along my armhole as well. Not very neat in places, I know, but it's going to be on the inside so it won't be seen. It was very tricky to do. I must admit this whole bodice has been very hard to do. Okay, now the next thing to do is to put your eyelets in. To save me explaining how you do this, you can either watch my bell bodice tutorial and zoom near to the end of that tutorial to see how it's done, or there's plenty of YouTube videos or corset YouTube videos that show inserting eyelets and how to do it. Now you basically use a special tool. These are 3mm size in silver. This is basically now what the outside of my corset looks like. I'll just put it on Betty for a better view. Okay, very quick look. Sides and then around to the back. On the top here I've just put some little hooks and eyes side there. Then it's all going to be laced up with silver cord. Next I'm going to be trying to create the front panel with all the crystals on. To achieve this was extremely difficult. But basically, it involved Mum wrapping some paper around me. She did take a picture, so you'll probably have to look on my website to see what we were doing. And it's basically as if you were drafting your own pattern pieces, to be honest. So she just covered me with all this paper because it had to go around a curve. And I first of all started drawing this flat. And by the time it curved around me, it just bunched up in all kinds of places, so I had lots of issues. So we had to do the other option in the end, with wrapping paper around me and Mum drawing the template around me. So this is the general shape we've come up with. And she has actually drawn the lines and the outline of this on this piece of fabric here, which is the same chiffon I used for the sleeves. and we've cut around it at least 2 more inches because we're going to be turning the edges over. We can't obviously leave them as they are because they will start to fray. But before I did this, I got a section of the fabric that was more a square rectangle shape, and I spray starched it. Now you have to be really careful because it's chiffon, but I just couldn't deal with this as it was, because if anybody knows what chiffon's like, it's very slippy. So I've stiffened it with this spray starch to make it a bit more manageable, and it made it just that little bit stiffer to deal with, because chiffon's a pain and it just slips and slides out of shape all over the place. It's very annoying. Anyway, that's my template. Next I'm going to be using this image, which is a really good image of the detail. So I'll be just showing you bits of that as I go along in a minute. Right, next up we're going to try and create this embellishment piece around the centre jewel here. And this is how we are going to go about it in the following instructions. Off I've cut a piece of wadding.
Using a compass, go from the middle point of your crystal to about an inch on the other side to make a half circle of wadding, and then just cut out the middle section there that would be going around your crystal.
Next up, you need a small size embroidery hoop ring, and we've cut out a big square of chiffon fabric here, placed it over the top of one of the rings, and then place the wadding in the middle. We then get another section and place that over the top. Okay, like so. Next, run an approximate sewing line around your piece. Next up, I bought these tiny sparkly pink seed beads that we think are about a size 15. They are very, very, very small. Let's get one out here. There we go. Very small. Next up, take a needle and thread, matching colour thread, and come up through the back.
Because these seed beads are so small, it is way too fiddly to try and put them on them one at a time. So you put them into a decent sized pot, like we've done. Then just using your needle, you're basically just fishing, running the needle through the beads. And if you can see that, I've picked up quite a lot of beads on the needle just by doing that. And I need to thread enough on there to go from one side of the padding to the other. I think I've put a few too many on that, so I should take a few off. With your needle. And then you take your needle down on the opposite side, and all the beads then will lay over the top of the wadding. Bring your needle back up right next to where you went down, and we'll do another one. So what you're going to be basically doing is doing that all the way across until you've filled up all of the wadding. The good thing about this is that if you do find you have a gap as you're going along, then you just go back, thread up some more beads and put them in between where there are any gaps.
Just quickly showing you halfway through, notice how we've changed the direction of the beads. Okay, next up after you finish beading it is to cut it out, and we'll be turning over the edges like so to neaten it off, and then we'll be sewing it to the panel piece over here. Just a quick look. It's not too tidy on the back, but we're not too bothered with that. And this will be placed here like so. That will also help give a bit of support to this button. The middle there like so, so I'm just going to go ahead and sew that down. Right, we've put some darts in here on this panel piece like we did with the rest of the bodice. We've now laid this panel over the top and we've marked out where our pattern is going to be from the pattern piece we did earlier. And we're just at the moment cutting around, leaving extra around the outsides, following the line that we've marked. Next I'm going to neaten the edge around the armhole. So I've been clipping and turning the edges inwards. Just to quickly show you the other side. You make little snips all the way along, and then that'll allow you to easily then turn it underneath for a neat edge. Next part, as it's really hard to see because there aren't many decent photographs, I've decided to go with some piping around the edge because I can see something silver on the one photograph around the one side of her, but it's a bit difficult to make out what it is. It's possibly piping or it might be a row of crystals, but I've decided to go with piping. I got this off a market stall. Not a craft shop or anything like that. I just saw it and I thought that would be pretty. What I basically did is started at the top here. And finished it there. I wrapped some salad tape around the end to stop it fraying and over sewed it with some silver thread. And then I got some fabric glue. Very carefully I started gluing this on bit by bit and then putting a weight on top of it because it needed to be held down for at least 5 minutes each section while it glued. And that just helped me put it in place all the way around. And then I've actually gone over it with little tiny, so you can't see it because it's silver thread, little tiny catch stitches. Just every so often to hold it in place, and especially down the bottom. I've gone over it quite a few times down the bottom. You can't actually go through the fabric there because there's a bone in place, so I've sort of had to go through the top lining bit. And when I get to the other side, I've stopped just before I need to, and I'm going to cut the end and wrap some salad tape around it, and then just sew it down the same as I did the other end. I can't say this is exactly the way they did it because this is the first time we've ever done anything like this, sewing a panel onto the front of a bodice. I personally thought maybe they'd sewn this on before the sleeve went in, but Mum had other ideas. She thought this would be the best way, so there's no arguing with her. This is it. But if anybody else has any ideas how they thought it might have gone on, we'd be quite interested to know. But as far as our knowledge is concerned, this is the best we can do. Next thing I've done is I've gone and cut around very carefully, stress very carefully, around the edges, the piping. In places I've had to go back and sew it, some of the piping back down again, but there's no bother. Just showing you guys quickly. Go. Okay, you ready for this? The bodice is now finished. Ta-da! This has been approximately 2.5 to 3 months' work compared to the actual construction, which didn't take that long compared to decorating it. I've used quite a mixture of things on here, so I'll go through it from top to bottom. I have some plain silver cup sequins, little tiny silver beads, pieces of diamante chain, stick-on stars, bicone pale pink crystals. I have some glass and some Swarovski, pieces of rope cord, some 3mm pink diamante chain used around the top here, and these stones are the same ones that are on the skirt. So refer, if you want to know where I bought these from, refer to the skirt tutorial. I bought some more pink beads, and these are basically just stuck on with glue. Underneath you'll see the pink glitter that I used on the peplum as well. I basically just water some glue down and sprinkle a load of glitter on. More Swarovski crystals in silver shade. And then some little, these flower appliques here I'm pointing at, not the diamante chain, I bought from India off eBay, they were on sale. Around here I have more Swarovski crystals, pieces of rope, some tiny 3mm silver Swarovski crystals. These jewels on either side are plastic acrylic. And then we have some more Lurik stars. I've worked really hard trying to replicate the pattern on her bodice. So basically carrying on with more bicone beads and some more rope. Coming around to the centre here, here's the piece we did earlier. I've used a heart-shaped button, which is plastic again. I thought that looked nice as a centrepiece rather than one of these round ones. I've then done sort of this Christmas tree sort of thing in the middle. Coming down a bit, more pink diamante chain. This is a little diamond shaped thing I've done and filled it in with lots of silver beads that are just glued on. Around here we've got some more Swarovski teardrop embellishments. Quite nice. And then we're going right to the bottom here. And again, more Swarovski crystals used around the cuff.